the look of the show is amazing. If you get closer to the artworks that will start playing as a GIF, and if you get close, you will see the caption and you know the last bit, so the history of the work and when it was acquired and entered the vault collection. All these little tricks that it's possible to play in Arium. I'm very, very happy about the space.
Yeah, it turned out really amazing. The texts are here, which is something, a unique experience that, you know, that you really don't get anywhere else, right?
Yes, and it is connected directly to Super Rare. That means that you don't have to manually add the caption, but you insert the token ID. Yes, if you click on the work, you can see the original file, and then you click to the link to Super Rare, and you go to Super Rare. And to have this caption, you just put the token ID, and it pops up. Like, it takes info from directly from Super Rare, which is pretty amazing. And also, yes, so the pieces are shown and displayed in chronological order. I hope that all of you watch the interview that we have done with XCopy. There are 24 art pieces.
We have created this experience where you could come in and you could see the questions that we asked. And it's optimized, so you could see here that when I'm far away, it actually doesn't start playing the artwork until you get closer.
Yes.
And like Eleonora was saying, everything's in chronological order from when the first piece was created by XCopy. So if you start over here, you can go through the entire, it's like this this retrospective of all the different art and how they changed their style a little bit as they went through, right?
Yeah, they evolved in time, of course. I mean, it's not an evolution, it's a evolution with the time, right?
You could see the history here of what happened, the bids and everything on Super Rare. I think that's a really nice feature that you wouldn't really get in another experience. So I think Arium really knocked out of the park with adding the different bids and description here.
Yeah, and it's even uploading automatically, which is amazing. It's not hand, you know, like handwritten manually. So it's very cool.
Very, very cool.
And also, you see, like, you can give like the you know the good thickness and depth to art pieces here, and you can put like a frame around the really. This is when I was talking about, like, he has more of like an artsy look, like a, you know, like a real gallery or less gamey. You know, you really think about, okay, what if I have this piece with me? How would it look? So you can give different, you have different options to display, which is pretty nice, I think.
Hey, look, it's a community member there. We really want to use this space to do these shows. I mean, every month, right? That's what we're shooting for. Yeah. And so, you know, this is the type of space that we can continue to modify and grow and put on these type of exhibits. Of course, the XCopy one is going to be here for most of the month of November. So that's going to be amazing for community members to come in and really explore the art and give them a chance to see what's going on here. And also they could talk about it. If you could get your microphone to work and your camera to work, you could talk about it. And that's exciting.
Yeah.
So yeah, this is the kind of space that we really love to show. And
next time that you have to have, like, you want to have a Google Meet or a Zoom, come here instead, because it's the same, only you are surrounded by all these XCopy's art. It's like being, you know, having a meeting in a museum or something, and you can discuss about art. And if you don't want to discuss about art, you still have the energy around, which is very different than having a meeting on a Zoom call. So really, like, the space is open. It's for the community. Come here. Come to chat. If you have to call each other, don't call each other. Just send the link of Arium that you all have. Come here to chat, which is better. So you can even, you know, see each other and walk together.
In this day and age, it's really hard to get together in real life right now. So having this type of virtual space to do the tours and everything, and get an art experience without leaving your house or being, you know, getting yourself exposed to anything. I think that's really important right now.
Now in Arium, yes, many experiences. I've made spaces like this. It's my favorite space in the metaverse. I really love Arium. And it's not because everyone is like, do you work for Arium? No. Is that your cousin? No, we're not family and we don't work together. But I really liked the concept of Arium from day first. So the only way I promote it is because I love it. And I would love for everyone to have a space like this.
We wanted to make this feel like it's, you know, it's very reflective. You could see the reflection on the pieces and yeah, and make it like a whale, like you're inside of this whale with the curves. And then, you know, we like this this space type of thing too. So it came out good. I think it came out really good.
Yeah. And it's all little details because in Arium, like when you change the light, it changes for real. It's like, you know, it's so cool. Based on how you play, we like, it's not pre-structured already. Like yesterday, I was talking about the light because I think that yesterday the light was lightly, like the sky was lightly darker. And so I couldn't see the lines of the architecture too well. So I was like, can we light a little bit more? And it's not that you go like there and you just made the sky, you know, lighter. No, you have to put more light to the whole space. And so the reflection on the actual building, the light that comes through the halls, everything changes because it's like a real light touching all the space. You know what I mean? It's not that you can just change the colors around. It's like if you have sun or you don't have sun.
Right, right, right. You have to have a light source. And I remember from my days of building game levels a long time ago, lighting and light sources are very important, especially when you want to show art, right? And if you don't have the light, then it's really hard to see.
Yeah.
Yeah. So this is great. This is like, it's really like a next level experience. So maybe you could tell folks.
So one that we did for Hakatao and Leonardo da Vinci with the head of a bear, that was very special because we also imported the 3D real, like the original 3D model of the head. And it was placed like in the center of the space and it kind of like comes down to you, but it never feels fake. Like it doesn't look like it's a, you know, like a video game. It feels like you are in a museum and there is a sculpture above your head.